As worldwide coastal erosion destroys our shores, 50% of our beaches are predicted to disappear by the end of the century. The Catalan coast in Spain is no exception.
I am quantifying the erosion in the last 50 years. So before the erosion, the beach was 50 meters wider than now.
'For these coastal regions, sand is scarce. With the construction of ports, dikes, and dams, the arrival of sediments from the rivers through the sea is blocked. This has modified the coastal currents of sediments along the Catalan coast. Manually replenishing the beaches by transporting sand has been a quick fix in recent years, but it has proven to be highly expensive and extremely unsustainable. For this reason, long-term eco-based planning is needed. In an effort to save their beaches, the government of Catalonia and the natural park in the region of Costa Brava teamed up with local residents, individuals who were already involved in preserving the morphology of the coast, like here at the campsite of Sant Pere Pescador.
The last major storm we have had in 20 years has been Gloria. Gloria has been known on the Catalan coast because it has done a lot of damage. Our place has been one of the most resilient ones. In our case, it did not affect us. We had almost no seawater inside the campsite. For us, this success is due to the dune we have maintained in the face of climate change. It was special, considering it was Gloria.
This northeastern coast of Spain is a beach dune system. Dunes are small hills of sand located in the upper beach area. It is this dune barrier that prevents a storm from damaging the land.
In 2020, we were invited to participate in the project of implementing barriers to stop the sand.
Sand traps are fences made of cane. With a porosity of 60%, they act as filters, letting the wind pass while blocking the sand. As the sand accumulates, the height and volume of the dune increases. To scientifically measure the effectiveness of these sand barriers, researchers within the IMPETUS project started documenting the changes at the coast in 2021. The researchers used drones equipped with various sensors and radars to generate digital elevation models. This allows them to measure the changes in the land's topography with centimeter-level precision.
The way we assess the beach with drones is that every single 3 months, more or less, we take a flight, and then we compare all the flights and we can obtain timing evolution during all the year. The results we obtain in Sant Pere Pescador are very, very, very good because we realize that sand fences are increasing the average height of the dune in 40%, which means that in 3 years, more or less, we obtain an average increase of 2 meters.
The researchers compare images taken before and after a storm. As the beach profile itself is flat, stormwater rapidly arrives on the inner side of the beach. The level of stormwater can be measured by the algae left behind through the storm tides. The dunes themselves stay untouched by the algae, as stormwater is unable to rise. Though some sand is eroded during a storm, over time, the dunes build up a large reserve of sand. Plus, the vegetation helps retain the sediment, creating a robust structure. Having achieved impressive results in a rural area, the IMPETUS project now aims to replicate these results in an urban area on the mid-southern coast of Catalonia. This area is home to around 70 coastal municipalities and about 43% of Catalonia's population. The city of Calafell is the first to join the project. 80 years ago, the beach of Calafell had dunes and vegetation at the coast. On this upper part of the beach, a promenade was constructed, and houses along the coast were built.
Climate events have been on the rise in recent years. In other words, they're getting more extreme. And the beach, lacking the natural protections it once possessed, and which we're now in the process of recovering, suffers and is transformed by erosion.
The city council has also chosen to remove an extension of their seawalk promenade to create a larger beach area. This new space will be receiving more natural deposits of sand in the coming future. If the deposits stay undisturbed, they will generate robust sand reserves.
Here in Calafell, people mainly depend on tourism. This is our economy. From this point of view, the beach is the most important entity of the entire municipality. There has never been a coastal protection strategy. There hasn't been any planning, and it seems that now that's beginning to happen.
The municipality of Calafell started installing sand traps in 2021 as a response to coastal erosion.
To me, the results we have obtained using these traps are a success, as this is an urban beach that is exposed to everything. Because we recover sand that would otherwise be transported by wind beyond the system towards the urban area. And with the creation of these forms, we foster slight changes in the beach profile so that the storms cause less erosion. Here you can see it perfectly. This sand trap was almost a meter high, and now we have all this volume of beach sand and dunes with vegetation, which are retained within the system.
The traps must be aligned with the wind regime, otherwise they will cause erosion. Other important factors to assess when building sand traps are the size of the sand grains, the type of sand, and the shape of the dune to be restored. This steady and firm layer of sand retention along 4 kilometers of beach area is the city's own new sand reserve.
One of the crucial aspects we require from the IMPETUS project is precise measurement of all the actions we undertake. This will enable us to draw conclusions and, importantly, to share our successes with the rest of the world and coastal communities.
As sea levels rise and the storms become more destructive, adaptive, short-term solutions like elevated homes and protective measures like dike walls are sought as help. But the natural restoration of the dunes will allow the beach to sustain itself and even thrive in the long run.